hey, we're about to leave. We're all packed up and we're ready to go. We're heading to my parents' house to drop the cats off. That's our first destination. So, see ya.
Bye bye to Moo Moo. He's not going to New York. Poor kitty. About 8 a.m., heading to our first stop, Weberville, and then off to the NYC. Oh, he doesn't want us to go.
Bye, Sam. Bye. Well, we are finally leaving Weberville. We dropped the kitties off at the grandparents, and we're headed back to the highway an hour later than we wanted to, because, you know, my mom loves to talk. But we're on our way. We're excited. Yay.
Officially left Michigan, now we're in Ohio. It's about 12:14 p.m. day one. Long ways to go. Yeah. 3:15 in the afternoon. We just now entered Pennsylvania, only 390 more miles to go. Still in Pennsylvania, I'm driving now, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, day one. Probably about 5 hours to go, or about halfway now. Another update, hopefully next time when we get closer to Jersey. That's about a couple hours. We're here. We're driving around to where our door is, and we're gonna park and go in. And next time you see me, we'll be in the room.
Creepy.
Well, we're here. This is our room. Travis is already on his computer. I know it's shocking, but this is where we're staying, and we're here. It's about 10 p.m. We're gonna go out, get some food, and then go to bed. See you tomorrow.
And she makes fun of me for being on the computer right away.
I'm just copying you.
We're ending day one now. I'm going to edit some of the footage from today. Which is kind of weird because, yeah, editing footage when I'm in the footage. Anyways, end of day one and off to the Big Apple tomorrow. We'll finally see it.
Hey, we're outside the hotel. We're about to catch the bus. It's coming around the corner right now. I'm excited. We're going to go into the city today. So I think Travis is about to crap himself. I'm so excited. But when we see you next, we'll be in the city. Seen Times Square, which is awesome as always, and we also took the subway down to the World Trade Center site, so we've been there, and Travis cried a little bit, and we're about to go see the Statue of Liberty, so see you there.
steer while scanning is in progress. Please refer to the home screen to see your current color moods. Prepare for a candy scan. Please refer to the view screen to see the color moon.
Hey, it's the end of day one. We're in Central Park. Today we have seen a lot of stuff for one day. We saw Times Square and Madison Square Gardens and the World Trade Center, a little bit of the Statue of Liberty. We've walked all over the place, but we're in Central Park now and it's really pretty out, and this is the end of day one. Tomorrow's another day.
Alright, to conclude day one, or technically day two, day one was the fun 12-hour drive, we're going to take a stroll through Central Park, something that I've never done, and probably those of you, if you're still watching, haven't turned it off yet, have not done either. So we're going to take a quick stroll just to conclude day two, and then tomorrow, another day in New York City.
Baby, you're my Zenodot. Pink candy, shiny color. question things you thought that you knew, for in Ripley's world, all things are possible, there's no taboo. Normal isn't normal, we never say too much. You can gasp, or you can giggle, but please don't touch. Everything is genuine, but nothing's what it seems. The monsters you've imagined in your wildest dreams are here, in Ripley's world.
This right here is a wall mural of stamps. It's really neat to look at, but it's all stamps.
Running around like a chicken with its head cut off is a common phrase. Running around like a chicken with its head cut off is a common phrase. Well, this is a headless chicken. And what's uncommon is that it ran around for 2 weeks. But that's nothing compared to the life of Mike the chicken. When the bird hit the chopping block, its brainstem remained and it lived for over 4 years. Its owner would feed it daily with a funnel and syringe. Miracle Mike even made it into Life magazine, and his hometown of Fruta, Colorado now holds an annual festival in honor of the decapitated bird. Festivities include an egg toss, chicken bingo, and of course, fried chicken for dinner. After years in the spotlight, the world's most famous headless chicken finally met its demise by choking on a corn. Unbelievable?
And what's uncommon is that it ran around for 2 weeks.
But that's nothing compared to life of Mike the chicken. When the bird hit the chopping block, its brainstem remained and it lived for over 4 years. Its owner, the chicken bingo, and of course, fried chicken. After years in the spotlight, the world's most famous headless chicken finally met its demise.
I'm not big enough to make it go off.
Sit back down again. Do it again, do it again.
Started over,
yeah. Do it again.
Huh?
Go. I can crop the video.
Travis has got a brand new pet.
13 torturous hours.
I don't think you can butt pet a hissing cockroach. I don't know, dude. That's gross. Huh? That's sick. Yeah.
I'm not here.
This is a cup at sea level on Earth. And this is what happens to that cup when it's taken 2.5 miles down where the Titanic sank. I don't want him to do something, right?
Get me out! Help me out of here!
Alex! Weiter rein!
Sorry.
Is made up entirely of one-armed players. And believe it or not, they need able-bodied players all the time. It's game time.
Suck him out!
By the fifth inning, the Bandits are losing ground.
8-6, Tom. 8-6. We're down by two, guys. We got to get back in this game.
But it's the eighth run that turns the tide. Bandit defense picks up. With a little hitting streak, the Bandits begin to rally. Soon, the score is 12-10 in favor of the Bandits.
They're missing the arm, and they're beating us.
Not only do the Bandits rally, but by the final inning, they end up blowing out their opponents 25-10. A truly amazing display.
Unbelievable? Believe it.
Most dogs love going for walks, but Nugget, a bull terrier from Australia, would rather run. That's right. Believe it or not, Nugget is the world's only skateboard riding dog. And you won't believe what she can do. Nugget began riding all on her own when she was only a puppy. Now, when she heads out for a cruise, cars stop and heads turn. And while other dogs just manage to simply stand on their skateboards, Nugget is in total control, incredibly using two paws to push herself along. In an amazing display of form, this talented terrier actually lifts her paw, leans into a double turn, and picks up speed the whole way. And while Nugget can go for hours without stopping, even this skateboarding hot dog needs a rest now and then.
Unbelievable? Believe it.
Since childhood, they're fitted with brass rings to elongate their necks to an unbelievable 8 inches tall. The bizarre tradition began as a way to prevent that Bochy's neck has been stretched.
Our bus actually stopped at the right place this time, so we didn't have to walk a mile down a busy highway to get to our hotel, so that's great. Today was rainy and cold, and we saw Ripley's Believe It or Not, which was freaky and interesting. that's about it. Oh, we saw CBGBs, kind of.
Kinda.
Not the real thing, but close.
But yeah, weather prohibited us from seeing most of the stuff, so.
We saw Freaky Oddities and Eight. And that's about the extent of our day.
Hopefully we'll see more.
Yeah. I'm sure tomorrow we'll be more productive.
That's day three.
Yay! Hey, it's day four. We're waiting for the bus. At least it's not raining today. That's good. But today we're going to go up and see, I think it's St. Paul's Cathedral. I don't know. St. Somebody's Cathedral. And then we're going to go to Central Park and basically walk the entire length, which will probably kill us, but it'll be fun. So, that's our plan. Bye. Hi, we're back from day four. We're both exhausted. We went and saw St. John's Cathedral today, which is the biggest cathedral in the world. And then we walked the entire length of Central Park, north and south, which is about 3 miles. So we're tired. Travis is performing like a grandfather, and it's pretty funny. But we're about to go back into the room and relax. So, bye. Day five now. Today we're gonna go to the Virgin Megastore because Maria from wrestling is there signing Playboys. I'm thrilled. So I think we're gonna go see if Travis can get his rocks off in the store first. Then we're gonna go to the Empire State Building, which will be way more fun in my opinion. And go to the top of that, and I don't know what else we'll do today. Maybe we'll do some shopping. Whatever. It'll be fun.
No, I'm going to stay. wrapping up day 5. We are falling apart, I think, from all the walking. Got like 7 blisters, one for each crown on my feet. Yeah, lame. We saw Statue of Liberty today. Saw Maria. Got some Playboy signage. Andrew loved it. Also saw Rockefeller Center. And Fifth Avenue. And that's pretty much today's events. And all we have left now is some shopping. No more Playboy signings, unfortunately. And the Empire State Building will close out the last 2 days, and we'll just plan it by weather. It's supposed to rain, so we don't know what we're doing yet, but yeah, that's day 5.
Here we are, day 6. One more day left after today. You can see the Empire State Building finally. Weather's not as good as we hoped it being. It's supposed to rain, so we're going to try to stay inside and do some museums. So today should be probably by ear.
Yeah, they do.
Play a chord.
Huh?
Play a chord. You can't do it that fast?
Too sure. You can do it.
No, I'm good.
I'll tell you which ones to step on.
Well, today is the end of day, well, tonight is the end of day six, and we're on top of the Empire State Building, which was cool. Did some shopping, bought some books, which I don't know why we couldn't have done back home anyways, but, you know, it's a souvenir that we can get back home to, right, that we got here. Anyways, yeah, that's pretty much all we did today, isn't that, Andrew? Yeah, shopping in Empire State Building. Ate lots of food. Oh, and had a really good margarita. That's day six, and tomorrow's our last day, so hopefully get some cool shots. If not, bon voyage, you know?
Last time going into the city, last time waiting for the bus, and of course it has to be pouring. My drive back tomorrow is going to be fun. There's a blizzard in Pennsylvania and Ohio, so that ought to be some interesting footage tomorrow. But for today, we're going to be nerdy and educate ourselves, hit up some museums, and possibly waste some time in another shopping center. And then that's day seven. We're going to head back to good old Grand Rapids tomorrow. Back to reality, which is reality.
No.
Well, end of day 7 and the week here in New York City. We're now back at the hotel room for our last night before we take our 12-hour drive back to Grand Rapids. So at this time, I just want to thank everyone for watching the film so far, but it's not over yet. We still have some highlights of our journey back because there's going to be a blizzard. So at this point, we don't know what the footage is going to be like, so hopefully we'll get some sweet shots. If not, it'll be just something that we put the credits over, and you'll find out in the next few minutes. So that's our film. We had a lot of fun here in New York City. I hope I come back soon, and basically just, you know, thank Andrea for making this all happen. And it's been an amazing week. So thank you for watching again. Day 7. And we're out.